massive bull elk right in front of me. He is a big elk. Okay, Tim Stewart. I don't know if you can see him or not, but he's waiting for you guys to come visit in October. There he is. He's looking right at me. And he is not scared at all. He's a big boy. Yeah, he doesn't care. He's just right back down to eating. Trying to be quiet. Man, I better make some noise or I'm gonna surprise him. Like, doesn't care at all. I've never been able to walk up on an elk like this. Well, Tim Stewart, here you go. There's your elk. He doesn't care I'm here at all. He just kind of meandered. Well, hey, Junior. Yeah, I'm here up where I took you and the kids shooting. And he ran right into the grass there. I'm wearing this bright red t-shirt, talking away. He didn't really care. I don't know, these elk are so comfortable in here. I don't think they've been hunted yet. But man, this is cool. This is gonna be really great. Man, very strange circumstances up here, guys. I have been doing a lot of shooting practices up here, long range pistol, shotgun, you name it. I've been doing it up here for about 15 years. And I had never really hunted much up here. I knew there was deer, a little bit of deer. That's really about it, a few ground birds. But just all of a sudden, within the last 2 to 3 years, wildlife has just been coming in here like crazy. There's a herd of elk of about 40 strong, and man, we've got all kinds of pigeons and doves and quails, cougar. Saw a sign of a great big bear last year, and bobcat. Got all kinds of stuff in here, man. I've been trapping and my traps are full every time I come through here, and I don't know what's changed. It doesn't look like anything's changed. You know, but we went from having zero wildlife to all of a sudden this place is great hunting, and the elk, as you just saw, it's gonna be fabulous this year.